So when we are dividing, just like when we're doing the product, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to divide our two terms. And then we're going to use the property of exponents for our power. So in this case, I'm going to have 5.5 divided by 5 times 10. Now, what happens when, you guys remember, when we multiply exponents, we add the powers, right? Does anybody remember what happens when we divide exponents? We subtract, right? Just like if I had x cubed divided by x squared, that equals x3 minus 2. So in this case, I'm going to have negative 2 minus a negative 2. And I forgot to change the powers on this one. But here would be a case where it's going to be 0. Anyways, now I need to divide 5.5 into 5. So we're going to go back to using our long division. 5 into 5.5. Now, yes? It's, well, this is a negative 2, and that's a negative 2.
No, but I thought when you minus a negative, it becomes a positive.
Yes, yeah, I'm going to get to that. I'll get to that point in a second. So in this case, we have 5 divides into 5 one time. 1 times 5 is 5. Subtract them, 0. 5 does not go into 0, though, so we need to put in a decimal point. Bring down the next number. 5 does go into 5 one time. So therefore, I have 1.1 times 10 to the s. When you have minus a negative, that becomes a positive. So it's negative 2 plus 2, which is, ends up going to give us 0. Now, obviously, 10 to the 0 power is just going to be 1. So your finalized answer would be 1.1. OK?